Listen, home cooking should be easy, delicious, and fun. So, here to take the stress out of the kitchen with some wonderful, uncomplicated recipes is chef and now cookbook author Claire Tansey. Yeah. You know what? It's like giving birth. You gave birth to your son, and then you gave birth to this book.
Yes.
Because it's been a journey.
Yes.
You know, it's been a journey, and I'm really proud of you. I know that we've been talking about this for a while, but to see it all come to fruition.
I know.
It's a beautiful book, and your name
Thanks.
Is on the cover.
I know my name. My son loves that. He's like, do you know your picture is in this book? I'm like, I know.
It's my book. Yes, which is amazing. So all the recipes are from Claire Tansey. The photography is stunning, and really it's about making it easy, easier for us.
Cooking
right?
does not have to be difficult to be delicious. You know that, I know that, but how do you get there, right? So tell me, Claire, how do I get to delicious with like fewer dirty dishes and fewer steps and less time in the kitchen, right?
Yes.
So let's start with the king of all easy dishes.
Yeah.
Roast chicken.
Chicken, chicken, chicken.
And people say to me, oh, roast chicken, it's complicated, right? You gotta have a rack, you gotta have the right pan, how do I know if it's cooked, etc. How do I tie it up? Well, here we go. Here is my chicken. You take them out of the package.
Right.
And I sometimes put them on a rack.
Yeah.
But if you don't have a rack, don't worry about it. Just put it right on the pan.
Okay.
And this is like, you can tell that this is a pan that has had love.
Yes.
It's not the perfect size. It doesn't matter.
Right. You can take this out of your little toaster oven or wherever you have a little rack.
Exactly.
That's easy.
Exactly. Okay. So now you think, okay, well, do I need to put bacon under the skin? Have I got to do like a herb butter? Mm-hmm. No. This is what you have to do. If you have some herbs, you're going to shove them inside.
So she's saying if, so don't even stress
if not,
out if
like,
you don't.
Honestly, we're having roast chicken for dinner tonight, and I will not be putting any herbs in.
Because you don't have any.
I don't have, although you know what? Actually, there's thyme still growing in the garden, so maybe I will.
Maybe I will.
Okay, now, for the very, very complicated next step, you take some plain canola oil and brush it all over the top. And I really like to leave the chicken like this. So I don't want to tie it up, actually, because I find it cooks a lot more evenly and it gets a lot more gorgeous when it's just allowed to sunbathe.
Okay, because it wants to chill out for a bit.
It wants to chill out.
Don't
and
tie it up.
You want that bit to get cooked.
Right.
You know, and if it's all tucked up like a cannonball, it doesn't get cooked very well. So, and then salt. And I always say, make sure you salt the wings because they are going to be delicious.
So this, I mean, the complicated parts would be the stuffing of and the tying up, and you've sort of taken those two things away.
I have. Yeah.
Which makes it so much easier. So is there anything else that we're going to do?
That's it. You're going to set the oven to 400 degrees and you're going to put it in there for an hour.
And you're going to walk away.
You're going to walk away. Okay, now we're going to, I'm going to put this half a lemon on there because I found it in the fridge and it's nice to have a little bit of roasted lemon.
Nice.
And that is it. And people say to me, I can't have roast chicken on a weeknight. Like it's a weekend thing. Sure, it's a weekend thing. But also if you got to come home and you want to like do homework or do anything else, pop this baby in the oven. An hour later, you are having dinner.
It's amazing.
And it's roast chicken.
That's
it's
amazing.
So good. So
all
that's
you gotta
number
do is
one.
Remember to take the chicken out of the freezer. That was always my job.
Okay, now listen.
If I did not take the chicken out of the freezer, there was hell to pay when mom got home.
Then you're gonna have something else tonight and you can have chicken tomorrow. No problem. Okay, now
what else are we making?
The next recipe is one of my absolute favorites. This is meatloaf.
Okay,
so meatloaf.
Yeah.
I feel like we forgot about meatloaf. Like it kind of went
it
the
went
way
away.
Of the 1970s or something.
Yeah.
It is the original uncomplicated menu recipe.
Mm-hmm.
Mixture of beef and pork. Here you go. You're gonna do some stirring, my friend.
All right.
Beef and pork because the pork is really flavorful.
Yep.
It brings a lot of tenderness. And you can always get ground pork at the grocery store.
Yeah.
So then we're gonna add breadcrumbs.
Yeah.
Whatever you've got.
Stick it all together.
This is a very-
Ketchup.
Yeah, man.
It's classy.
It's classy, and I can tell you, I have tried to make this without ketchup, and it is not as good. So don't even try.
Okay.
Couple of eggs.
Yeah.
This is just going to kind of help things to
bind.
Hold together and that stuff. Okay. Now, dried thyme.
Uh-huh.
One of the only dried spices that, or dried herbs, dried green herbs that I like. Everything else just seems to have no flavor. Dried thyme, delicious.
Okay, you're okay with that. Everything else, you go fresh.
And
usually.
Usually go fresh. I mean,
if you can.
Or skip it. Yeah. Now, speaking of fresh, here is some beautiful fresh parsley.
Yeah.
I would love to add this to this meatloaf, but if I'm going to eat it, My son's not going to eat it with the green stuff in it.
Right.
You know what? We're
because there's green things in there.
There's green stuff in there, Mommy.
You ruined it.
I'm a terrible, terrible person. Okay. Now, here is a trick. One of my favorite tricks. My sister gave me this because she tested this recipe for me, and she's a smart lady, and she cooks a lot. And I was chopping up the onion to put the onion in, dicing. She's like, oh, Claire, just grate it.
Oh, good for her.
Because not only is it faster, you don't have to use your knife, but also it then disperses in the meatloaf, and it gives you better flavor. And also it disappears for those little people who maybe say, I'm not going to eat anything that has chunks in it, Mommy. All those things. So then since you have the grater out, use that for the garlic as well.
The grater is your friend. Everything looks better when it's grated up, too. Like, try putting grated carrot on a salad. It looks way better than if you just chopped it up in chunks, right?
And you just stir that all up, plunk it in a... what is this thing called?
A pan.
A loaf pan.
Yeah.
You can see
one of those things.
I haven't had enough coffee today.
Yeah.
Bake it for an hour. And again, you put it in the hour, you forget about it, and then you have dinner with some beautiful, easy 5-minute vegetable sides.
Yeah.
And that's it, man.
Frozen peas.
Frozen peas, a bit of bottled meat sauce.
Ooh, nice.
Mint sauce. Frozen peas, mint sauce. And that is a grated carrot with some lemon juice in it.
See what I said about the grated carrot?
Hell yeah.
It's so good. And you also put this on top of your meatloaf. So what is that? Is it barbecue sauce?
It's HP sauce, like brown sauce. You can use ketchup. You can use barbecue sauce. Just gives it that nice little bit of a glaze on top here.
Yeah.
Guys, it's hard for me not to just pick this up and eat it like an apple. I love meatloaf.
Yes.
I love this so good.
She's actually going to do that as soon as we go to commercial break. But I like that. It should be uncomplicated cooking and uncomplicated eating, right?
Yeah.
Well, with easy ways to get a homemade dinner or on the table, Claire's new cookbook, Uncomplicated, is out right now. We're going to draw for copies after this show.
Yay!